Hello, everybody, and welcome to Romanceful's Tarot. I'm about to begin here with a reading. Now, this is a general reading, so it might not resonate with everybody. So it really is important that you do take whatever does resonate with you and you simply leave the rest of it aside. Now, if you do have any questions, if you would like to contact me, you would like to have your own reading, please do so. You can find all of my information, contact, and a list of my readings right below into the YouTube description box. So please do check it out. If you wish to contact me, it will be my great pleasure. Please do not hesitate. Also, if you do enjoy the channel and you have not yet subscribed, please do take a brief moment of your time to click the subscribe button to show your support to the channel and to myself. And it is always and greatly appreciated, and I do thank you so very much. So with no further ado, let's begin this reading. I have four messages here coming from Spirit for you, and I am going to conclude with a message from the soul. So a soul message. Let's begin with the Spirit. Be proud is your first message. Ground yourself, let go, and listen. So let's begin with be proud. It is time to celebrate all that you have achieved, all that you are, and all that you are going to become. Now, every once in a while, it's important to just stop. To acknowledge what you've achieved and to be proud of yourself. Spirit is so very proud of you. The spirit world wants you to stop right now and to listen. They want you to honor the hard work that you've done, and they want you to pat yourself on that back. Whether you've moved through a difficult or a painful situation, achieved significant success at work, conquered a new skill, learned a language, beat your personal best in your favorite sport, or simply that you just let go of everything that was holding you back for your highest good. This message by Spirit is letting you know how vital it is to honor and to acknowledge yourself by feeling proud. You need to pause for a few minutes. You need to hold this message. Think about it. Enjoy the moment while you bask in your own pride. And as you let the warmth of that feeling simply wash over you, you feel that sense of achievement and smile for the whole world to see. Right now, it's all about celebrating your successes. And once again, you have to be proud of how far you've come. And you need to have faith in how far you can go. Moving on forward now to your second message I do have over here, ground yourself. So, you have to be careful with being distracted, being unfocused, tired, maybe irritated, maybe impatient. They're all signs that maybe you are a little bit ungrounded. Now is the time for you to become centered and to allow Spirit to help you ground yourself and reconnect with a divine source. Spirit has carefully selected this message for you for a reason. It is now vital for you to ground yourself in order to clear your head and to stop the racing, stop the frenetic, the chaotic, the thoughts that are sending you into a million different directions. It is time to take a firm step back so you can think clearly again, so you can achieve your full potential. You need to reconnect with a divine source, but to do so, you have to ground and you have to center yourself. Spend some time in the peace and the tranquility of nature. Whether that's a countryside or at the beach, wherever it is that you can be with yourself, by yourself in nature. Take time to meditate if you do meditate. Breathe and absorb the healing qualities of stillness and serenity. And by doing that, simply by grounding yourself, you are going to align with your highest soul purpose. And yet, you're still keeping both feet firmly onto the beautiful ground. Moving over to letting go. Now, once you let go of the outcome, you're going to be able to release all of the emotional constraints that have held you back in the past. You need to trust in the higher good and guidance of Spirit. Because Spirit, they only have your very best intentions at heart, and they will do everything in their power to protect you. So Spirit is here to show you that by letting go of your preset outcomes, it is sometimes just necessary for you to take an alternative route to your destination in life. Equally, as you navigate your new route, you may find that the ultimate destination, that it changes to one that's for your higher good. So don't ignore the signs, don't ignore the symbols that are presented to you at this very time. This is spirit providing directions, providing pointers to guide you along your journey. You must be brave. You must let go of the plans and the ideas that are not working. You have to trust and follow the energy that is guiding you in a new direction. Energy is like the ebb and the flow of the tide, and through a higher awareness, you can tap into that energy and you can flow with it. Past inhibitions, self-doubts, confidence issues that fade away as you let go and you trust that spirit is going to guide you to where you need to be. Moving on forward to your final message before moving over to your soul message, we have listen. Now, you have to be willing to listen if you want to really understand someone. And now is not the time to be offering any advice, but it's a time to be compassionate, to be a compassionate listener. To listen fully and to intently means to pay attention, not just to what's being said, but to what lies beneath those words. Now, Spirit has heard, has listened to your requests in the past. So Spirit is bringing this message to you because someone around you needs to be heard right now. They're not seeking advice, but they really need to express themselves about how they are feeling and what is going on in their life. What they're seeking is an open, a compassionate, and a non-judgmental listener. So when you're intently engaged in conversation, there's an even energy exchange where both parties can benefit. And those who are talking express what they're feeling, and just by the process of talking, they're often going to solve the problem or the issue all by themselves. So being present and listening to someone who needs your full attention is, in some cases, going to bring you the answers that you have been seeking for yourself. So you need to listen. To moving over to your final message I have over here with the soul, we're going to be speaking about truth. So this is all about finding your own personal truth. It's about being honest with yourself. It's speaking your heart. It's walking your talk. And follow your inner guidance in all the activities. You are the truth. Listen for what is sincere and honest in others. Your soul right now wants you to know that often the hardest thing about living your truth is knowing what that is. That there's a place inside of you that always knows what's true for you and what isn't. And sometimes it takes sincere silence and deep stillness to find that voice. But once you do discover it, let go of anything in your life that isn't authentic. Release relationships that don't empower you and situations in which you find yourself being less than honest for fear of being judged or not accepted. Miracles follow when you take the time to be genuine. This is about telling yourself you have to live your own truth. And this does conclude your reading. I do hope that you enjoyed. I do hope that it brought you some interesting messages that you'll be able to use. If you do have any questions you would like to contact me, please do so. It will be my great pleasure to assist you. All my information is right below into the YouTube description box. If you have not yet subscribed, please do subscribe. And I wish you a beautiful day. I thank you for being there. And I will see you tomorrow with new messages. Many blessings to you.